Hare Krishna. I seek the blessing of all the assembled Vaishnavas so that I can get myself purified and I can progress in spiritual life. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. So today's verse, there's a chapter, The Curse Upon the Yadu Dynasty. Here, Lord Krishna, first point is that he's decided to wind up his pastime. And while winding up his pastimes, he's just thinking the entire Yadu dynasty is there. So, they are very dear associates, great devotees. And Lord wanted to make them disappear from the Yadu dynasty. And then he is thinking of disappearing from this world. Past time. And it is said they are very powerful and they are very pious also. Since they are very pious, they could take birth in Yadu dynasty. And they are completely surrendered to Krishna. And it is Krishna's own family. So, whatever Krishna plans out, that is a perfection. It's always perfect. Actually here, the acharyas, especially our Jiva Goswami, he says, this pastime of the Yadu dynasty, this activities of Supreme Lord never taken as an ordinary material activities. Nor Lord's associates are ordinary people. They are very, very pious and very, very lovable to Krishna. And the main reason, there are two reasons, these acharyas, they say, one reason to clear up Yadu dynasty is that they can't bear the absence of the Lord. They wanted to come with him only because you have to wind up. And second thing is that if he leaves them there, they are so powerful and they'll get disturbed. They will trample everything. There will be distress. So Lord, keeping these two points in mind, Lord wanted to make them disappear first, then he will disappear. This was his plan. And actually, here Acharya says about the qualities of this Yadu dynasty. They are very powerful, having all the opulences. But they had the qualification to take birth in Yadu dynasty, because they were all associates of Lords, and as well as the demigods, they have come to help the Lord's pastime. Now Lord has got his own way how to make them disappear from him, from there. That's why he gives an example. This, in the forest, two bamboos, they rub each other and then there will be fire starts and whole forest will get burnt. So he plans in such a way that they should fight themselves and they should disappear from here. And it is said, even Acharya says, you cannot expect any irreligious things with them. They are really very sincere and very pious and great devotees, Yadu dynasty. We should not misunderstand, even Acharya said. Even their power was so much, entire universe, nobody can insult them also. Forget about killing or making them defeat. It's impossible. They are very powerful. Because they have taken shelter of Krishna. The mercy of Krishna is there. Also, Acharya says, these devotees, these Yadu devotees, even whatever the time they are speaking, they are walking, they are sitting, any work they are doing, they are totally engrossed and absorption of Krishna's meditation. They are thinking about Krishna. They forget themselves also sometimes. They are so powerful. So in this condition we can't think that because of their irreligious purpose Krishna wanted to take them out or send them back to their original abode, make them to disappear. No. It is Lord's real planning. Even though some show may be there, but it is the will of the Lord. As we rightly know that in Mahabharata, Lord made Arjuna to be totally, you know, a person who is not understanding anything like. He has put him as an instrument. So Krishna has to give the Bhagavad Gita for us. So in between Arjuna got bewildered. This is what Krishna's play. And same way even our Parikshit Maharaj, he got the curse. Within 7 days, he had to leave the body. He did not go for retaliate the thing. And he said, this is mercy of Krishna. This is Krishna wanted. And Shukadeva Maharaj arrived there and we got Srimad Bhagavatam. This is the play, real play actually. It's all inconceivable thing. We can't understand that. Now here one wonderful word is that I wanted to just highlight on that. This is Mare Krishna Rake Ke, Rake Krishna Mare Ke. This is even Prabhupada used to speak most of the time. If Krishna wanted to kill, nobody can save. If Krishna wanted to save, nobody can kill him. Because he is the whole and soul. He is the supreme personality of Godhead. When Prabhupada had 2 heart attacks, that time Prabhupada was having the same thing. Mare Krishna Rake Ke, Rake Krishna Mare Ke. Then Krishna comes in his dream and he gives him the protection. So Prabhupada gets that total faith and he did not go after going there, how much damage took place, let me go to the doctors, find out where are the blocks and all. He was totally, having totally faith on Lord's word. Srila Prabhupada had. And now the even we can refer our Parikshit Maharaj. When Parikshit Maharaj, when he was asking the question, because he was comparing my grandfather Arjun who was fighting in the battle, really speaking he had to face Bhishma Pitama, Dronacharya, Karna, these were all the Timingalas. Very strong commanders they were. Very difficult to defeat them. And my grandfather Arjun was like a small fish. That big Timingala can eat that fish at any time. Even though Arjun was very powerful, but front of them, it was very definitely impossible. This is the realization what Parikshit Maharaj was given. Why they were victorious? That was the grace of Krishna. Here we can understand, Mare Krishna Rake Ke, Rake Krishna Mare Ke. If Krishna has to save, nobody can kill. This is Arjuna's particular thing. Here one more highlight is there that especially this Yadu dynasty, this class was given in December 1973, Srila Prabhupada. It was, lecture was 1.15.25.26. When the Yadu dynasty became very powerful, because they are descendants of Krishna. So, they are fighting anywhere, conquering anywhere, and everywhere they were victorious. So that was the Bhubharan. Means this is the, you know what meaning of Bhubharan? Bhubharan means burden of the world. One becomes, this is Prabhupada's word, when one becomes extravagant in the misuse of his power, that is the burden of the world. This we should note it. There is some power is there. If that power is not properly used, if it is misused, that will be a burden. And further, you cannot misuse power. You get power from the grace of God, whatsoever the power we are having. By grace of Krishna, if you misuse them, then you become burden. It's very nicely Prabhupada has stated. The Yadu Vamsha, it is a Krishna's dynasty. When Krishna saw that they are becoming so powerful, that unnecessarily they are fighting, therefore, to kill them, that fighting spirit was engaged for fighting amongst themselves one another. In that way, Lord arranges the disappearance of Yadu dynasty. In this we can learn, see now, how that Parikshit Maharaj spoke about Arjuna and how Arjuna was such a person, but all this commander-in-chief, Timinglas, by them he could win. Whereas, here one of the parts Prabhupada has said, and it is in the Srimad Bhagavatam 1.15.5 purport, Pandavas retire timely. We have to just, please hear it. When Lord descends on the earth along with His eternal, ever-liberated associates, He not only displays the divine energy possessed by Himself, and also powers His associates, devotees, with required energy to execute His mission of incarnation. He properly gives them proper energy and all power. Now, if in our case, if we see, Lord has given everyone certain power, even in our ISKCON movement also. You can see there are so many abilities. There are very special preachers, special kirtankars, there are special book distributors, and there's DT dressing people. So many, even management level, special power. But these powers are all by the grace of Krishna. He has given it. When the time comes, sometimes Lord withdraws the power. This we should understand. When it was necessary, essential and emergency, Lord empowers. That time, other time He takes out. Even same thing, financial condition for grahasthas. Some necessity is there, He empowers, He gives lots of finance. And the necessity is not there, He withdraws all the finance. That is, now it's enough. This is the power. And second point, Srila Prabhupada says, similarly, the Lord takes away with Him all His associates when He disappears from the earth. It is always the case. Third, the power and energy which were bestowed upon Arjuna were required for fulfillment of the mission of the Lord. Even it is for us. Whatever power we are having, it is for the fulfillment of the Lord's mission. Very true. But when his mission was fulfilled, the emergency power were withdrawn from Arjuna because the astounding powers of Arjuna, which were astonishing even the denizens of heaven, were no longer required. And they were not meant for going back home back to Godhead. This power at the time of to go back home back to Godhead is not needed. Only at the fighting time it is needed. You may be remembering, when Lord finishes pastimes, Arjuna, he was there, gone to Dwarka. Yudhishthira Maharaj sent him to see meet them. And he understood that, now I'll take this queens to Hastinapur. He started taking them. And that ordinary coward man, he came and defeated Arjuna very badly. His Gandiva, he could not lift it. Because totally his power was withdrawn. It was not needed. Very, very practical thing it is. And even continuously we get the old age. Disease. And our power is automatically stopped. It'll slow down. It will be there. And plus, after this, by putting that situation, we become humble. Now I can't do it. We become humble. That power gets weaker and weaker. We become humble. That humble, that humility is essential for connecting ourselves to back home, back to Godhead. We can get out of this material connection. Otherwise, if the passionate power is there, person will never understand that. This is rightly given. And Srila Prabhupada would say, he used to say, this material place is very cruel place. And why it's cruel place? Even though if you wanted to stay here, they won't allow you to stay here. When the time comes, what this place, people, the thing happens, the death will come, that will say, you rascal, get out from here. This is the word of Prabhupada. Get out. Enough. That's why it's a kick we are getting, and that's why it is called very cruel place. When Prabhupada was there in western country, one example I wanted to give, that he kept up this, every power comes from Krishna. When he was in the Jaladutha itself, he considered, Lord, I am just a puppet. I cannot do anybody, nobody can get transformed by my preaching. I do not know anything. You can make them to Krishna conscious, not myself. Use me as a instrument. You can make them. This spirit of spiritual potency and that power and that humility, Prabhupada kept it up to the last. This, everything comes from Krishna. And when he was in Bauri, he was giving the class to the hippies. Hippies were giving great respect to Prabhupada. And Srila Prabhupada was saying, I am not deserved for this credit. I am just a postman peon. I am a delivery boy. I just bought it and I am giving you. It is not mine. This is my spiritual master, Guru Maharaj and Krishna's asset I am giving you. This is even up to the last, Prabhupada kept up that. Here, one more thing Prabhupada is mentioning. If endowment of powers of withdrawal of power by Lord are possible even for a great devotee like Arjuna or even a demigods in heaven, then what to speak of the ordinary living being who are but fixed compared to such great souls? Actually, one small narration I wanted to do. It was His Holiness Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj said that. It was like that. It was 1977. Prabhupada was quite sick in Vrindavan. Now all the disciples of Prabhupada, Tamal Krishna Goswami, Giriraj Maharaj, they were all so much worried. They wanted to see Prabhupada should be happy sometime. So that time, Ghanshyam, or Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj's earlier name was Ghanshyam. He was the topest book distributor. He was totally empowered by Prabhupada. He never even looked here and there. Every moment he used to use it for Krishna's service. Very powerful. So he had come there. That time Prabhupada could understand Ghanshyam is arrived. Immediately Prabhupada, he forgotten all his sickness. He was waiting. Where is Ghanshyam? Where is Ghanshyam? He just, when Ghanshyam had come, he embraced him very happily, lovingly, with tears. And he whispered something on his ear. Later they came to know what he whispered. Srila Prabhupada whispered, "My dear Ghanshyam, I am very grateful to you. I am very proud of you. And you have perfected your life. I am very happy. You have taken Krishna consciousness seriously." Prabhupada whispered it. Very happy. And people saw it. Our His Holiness Tamal Krishna Goswami Giriraj Maharaj said, "Prabhupada is very happy with this Ghanshyam. Let Prabhupada be happy like that only. Tomorrow's news to be read by Ghanshyam. World news. ISKCON news." So they said, and even Bhakti Tirtha Maharaj said, "I was so happy. Prabhupada is very happy. And we have to see that Prabhupada should be happy." So he started taking the sheet and started reading the world news of ISKCON. Damodar Bus Party has done so much book distribution. That party, this one, Australia, Africa, all the places. And one, he told himself here in this same place, "I just read one message, then I look to Prabhupada. Prabhupada is least bothered. He was not looking at all. Yesterday he was so happy, today he was so unhappy, I could see. I said, why I started reading this? Prabhupada is unhappy." He was just reading one message and looking at Prabhupada. And Prabhupada was least bothered. He was not looking at all. Now, finally the news got over. Then Prabhupada just lifted his hand. "You know, Krishna is the doer. Krishna is the doer." This word he said. This is what we have to understand. Akanda. Whatever the business we are doing it, the entire thing is monitored by Krishna. This we should not forget. By seeing this, that's Prabhupada never forgot that. Even up to the last. On the contrary, there is an exalted sannyasi from Radha Damodar. And he was front of the hippies, he was saying, "I am not deserved for any credit." So much humility. Even up to the last. That's why Prabhupada, one most important thing he says, the lesson here, therefore, no one should be puffed up for his powers borrowed from the Lord. Very instructive it is. All power. For our power, or you have the power of the present stage of market, how to do that. Everybody has got his own power. But all this power was borrowed by Krishna. We should never get puffed up. What happens by that? Person becomes, he gets the pride makes him proud. Then with that proud, he becomes offensive, aparadha. Very important. Becomes aparadha. Very small little things. Anything can happen. Anywhere, to anyone. We have that 10 offensive system is there. That is there. Out of that, so many other things it will be there. And one more thing is, such power can be withdrawn at any time by the Lord, so that best use of such power and opulence is to be engaged them in the service of the Lord. Rishikena Rishikesha Sevanam Bhakti Uttama. It should be used for the service of the Lord. All the senses to be used for the service of the Lord. Just to use the service of the Lord, the power has been given. Regarding the offense, even I'll narrate one small story, of course, in an incident. It was about 15 years before. It was held in Udipi. Happened in Udipi that was the Palimar Math Swamiji's Paryaya was there. I don't know what happened. There's an elephant was there. The elephant was doing wonderful service of Lord Krishna. Just carrying the Lord's Ussavamurti. It's going in front of the chariot all the time. And the early morning it comes, takes darshan of the Lord. So many things. It was the main member of the temple. So one day what happened? Elephant got mad. It was become crazy. And he went up, even his mouth could not come front of him. He went up entire way and kicked so many shops. And people were all running. He's not looking anything. Quite chaos. Everywhere it was running. This elephant became mad. And it was taken, even curfew has been put on that area. Couple of days. And it was the biggest problem. And then what happened? So at last some forest people have come. They shoot some anesthesia injection and made the elephant to sleep or something like that. But after with amongst the 8 Matas Swamijis, they have discussed what is gone wrong. He is the main person. We can say he is the main head pujari of the Krishna's worship. What has happened like that? Then you know what they did? They understood that some great aparad has been taken. So all 8 Matas Swamis, they have gone and straight away they gave dandavat and praying Krishna, please forgive us. Something happened knowingly, unknowingly. You can forgive us. With the tears they were praying. So Krishna helped them. And same way, it remembers. Then, you know ultimately what happened? The next day, the elephant became alright. Next day we could see, there were some, our ISKCON boys were distributing book. And they were all called in very, very five-star treatment. You come for prasadam. You know? There should not be any offensive. They are all Vaishnavas. Very nicely, because people get transformed themselves by seeing this incident. They become more humble. Whatever is Krishna is arranging, it is our best purpose. It's the best thing what we are getting. The same way even we are taking some of the departments, managing, even being a ISKCON devotees, we should be very careful. What is our Siddhanta? How we have to be careful? We don't know. There may be so many great people we are knowing their name and all. Expert class giving people, expert counselors, expert GBCs. These are the great people are there. Temple commanders. Not necessarily. There are so many people, so many souls who are coming. Very simple. We don't know. We don't know them. But they are the pure souls. Krishna is giving them. They are all the children of the Lord. Though they are in that position, we should be very, very careful. The power we got it, but utilizing the power totally on keeping Krishna in center, like Srila Prabhupada. Even up to the last, he never expected any type of respect, whatever Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said. Trinadapi sunischena tarurapi sahishnuna amanina manadena kirtaniya sadar. This basic sutra, this basic tattva cannot be changed at all. when we become some powerful people, the tattva is different. No, there will be reaction. Very important. And all these particular things, we can get ourselves properly molded or transformed by chanting the holy name. And one place, Srila Prabhupada used to say, this everyone has to remember, because after many, many lifetime, after passing many, many lifetime, you know, all 84 lakhs of species were all gone through. Finally, then we got 4 lakh species of human being. And Prabhupada used to say, after coming to human being's life, it should be your main goal that you have to become a pure devotee. Like that, whoever takes birth in Bharat Varsha, India, they are all devotees. But you have to become pure devotee. Pure devotee means you have to surrender it. And how? Then Prabhupada gives a quotation. Bahunam janmanamante jnanavan mam prapadyate vasudevam sarvamiti samahatma sudurlabha. After many, many life, many, many species, then we came to this human life. After this human life also, after many struggling, we get an intelligence. Jnanavan. What is that intelligence? Prabhupada says, Krishna is everything for me. I am Krishna's. Krishna is everything for me. He is Samahatma. He is Mahatma. He is intelligent. Krishna is everything. Nothing more than that. Danya hoga, kritartha hoga. I have to take shelter of Krishna. I was not knowing, for many life I was not knowing. By the mercy of spiritual master and all Vaishnavas, I came to know the position of Krishna. My job is to surrender to Krishna. For that purpose I got this human form of life. This is the highest perfection I have to do. Highest perfection is Krishna consciousness. It is the highest. Srila Prabhupada used to say, you have to go to the peak. Highest. So for highest peak, you have to go to Himalaya. Then after going to Himalaya, you have to see that what is the highest? Mount Everest. Let me go to Mount Everest. Krishna conscious means Mount Everest. Now enough. Your life is perfect. You have perfected your life. Krishna conscious is that. Two. Krishna is capable of totally protecting us. This we should know that. This was Arjuna's consciousness. Whatsoever the, there was 11 Akshayani senas for Kauravas, and these people had only 7 Akshayanis. And they were Ichha Maranis. They can only die whenever they wanted to die. Bhishma Pitama and Dronacharya. These people are Ichha Maranis. And only 18 days, within 18 days they have to complete it. They were sure. Even Dhritarashtra was sure at least one person out of 100 will remain. And we will be victorious. But no. Krishna knows what is dharma and what is adharma. Krishna has to make Yudhishthira as a king. Dharmai rakshati dharma rakshati. This is the essence. And this is the essence. Krishna is competent to protect me. This was the essence Arjun had. Prabhupada says, you should have Arjun's consciousness. Arjun's mood. I don't bother even nobody is there. But Krishna is there. The victory is 100%. If Krishna is there, if Krishna is not there, everything is finished. This is the, we should have the consciousness of Arjun. Where here, especially, Krishna mare rake ke, Krishna rake mare ke. We hear it. But realized thing is, Srila Prabhupada had it. He has undergone. He understood. This is the realized thing. And one more, finally, taking shelter of Krishna, Sharanagati, is only the goal. Jivare Swarupe Krishna Rinityadas. This is the final. Otherwise you have to take birth again. This should be our last birth. Nothing doing. It will be done. It's possible. Even though chanchalai mana Krishna, mind is moving here and there. There's about something like, it is some calculation has been done from some experts nowadays. Something like 80,000 thoughts are coming in a day for our mind. Out of that 80,000 thoughts, you have to keep Krishna in center. It's a difficult job in Kali Yuga. Dhrita nischita. You have to be real determination. And we understand this particularly. What was the way Prabhupada took it? And Krishna is taking care. One who takes shelter, surrenders in full way. And there, I have taken shelter of Krishna, whether in danger he is going to protect me or not, this doubt should not come, because Krishna is going to, 100% he is going to protect you. He is an absolute truth. And when you become pure, absolutely you will have full faith. That fourth day full faith, you have to chant the holy name all the time. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Thank you very much. Time up. We have to wind up our time. Krantara Srimad Bhagavatam ki, Srila Prabhupada ki.